What's going on, all you ghouls and ghosts out there? My name is Mike Macabre, and welcome to the graveyard. And on tonight's episode, we have another reviews and reactions for you guys. And on tonight's episode, who do we have the pleasure of listening to? Let's take a quick look here. We're coming back with Wumpscut and their song, Golgotha. This request comes from Peter Stevens, and full disclosure, I do know all about Wumpscut and this song, and this is going to be a nice little treat. Link to the original video will be in the description box for your viewing pleasure, but without further ado, let's check out some more Wumpscut, huh? We have Wumpscut with their song Golgotha off the Embryo Dead album. Let's check it out. Just a little bit. This is a driving beat. I think it was the back beat. I haven't heard this song in at least 10, 15 years. It's been that long, so I'm sure it'll come back to me as far as lyrics are concerned, but I do love this song.
Thank you.
thought I was gonna end there. I forgot. All right, man, nostalgia for real, but I'll say what I need to say in the review. I'll see you guys there. All right, that was Wumpscut with their song Golgotha. This request comes to us by Peter Stevens, and the link will be in the description box for your viewing pleasure. Okay, I closed my eyes throughout most of the song because I was really feeling the song. It transported me back to when I was a little angsty, depressed teenager. That's when I first found Wumpscut. I want to say early 2000, 2001, with the album Wreath of Barbs. Still to this day, on that album, the self-titled track, Wreath of Barbs, one of my favorite Wumpscut songs. Wumpscut comes, I think his name is Rudy Ratzinger. I'm not 100% on that. It's been so long since I've listened to Wumpscut, like I said. I think the last album that I listened to was Cannibal Anthem. That's the last one I bought. And then on that album as well, there's another top-tier song. I think it was Jesus Antichristos. I would love to be able to react to that. I don't know if I'm going to. If you put it in the comment section, the 6 feet under, I will definitely add it to the queue. I'm not saying anybody has to, but if you do, you do. I would be thankful. but if I had to give this a score, I'm going to give it a 4.5. The only thing that's keeping it from that 0.5 to give it that 5 skulls out of 5. It tends to be a little bit of a repetitive song. There's not much happening musically, per se. The entire weight of the song is in the lyrics. They are very meaningful, very poignant lyrics about Golgotha, which is also known as Mount Calvary, or the hill that Jesus was crucified on. And Mr. Ratzinger, through his lyrics, depict, you know, the Lazarus got the wrong guy, they crucified the wrong man. And the fact it's ironic that a Jewish man was crucified on a Roman's cross. So there's that, and Judas and all that, and the biblical ramifications and repercussions of that particular happening. This was at a time when I was very, I was struggling a lot with religion and that sort of thing. I'm not going to go too much into it, but it really resonated with me when I was a teenager, and it still has some pull. I got chills from this song for sure. Blast from the past. Absolutely love it. Appreciate the request. Brought back a lot of memories, some good, some bad. I'm glad I'm not depressed like that anymore. It was quite tough, but music helped me. This band helped me, among others. Rammstein, Funkervoet was another one that I listened to a lot. And they kept me alive to where I am right now. And I'll just leave it at that. But I think that's going to be it for today's episode of Reviews and Reactions. If you like what you saw, as always, like, subscribe, comment, share the video, hit that notification bell, as always, you ghouls and ghosts, and as always, stay scared.